Something more filling. I'd hope for something more meaningful. I'd hope for something just more perfect. To put it eloquently, that was trash. Though, I guess your screw up gives us the opportunity to swap roles. So, for this once, let me be the one who gives the narrative of reality, as opposed to the fabricated utopias, as you rest with the refreshing taste of pessimism. Where do I begin? Oh, yes. Crappy performances like that are always quick to remind me that I live in a terrible reality. Then again, that's the least of our problems amidst this grim depression. There are definitely some things worse, some people worse, such as those politicians who imply that this current predicament of ours was merely a clumsy mistake in order to preserve the collective free will. I guess the standard American was played for a fool. And now we're at the precipice of national collapse, and are left to the mercy of the same people who crippled us. It's pretty absurd that Americans would put their trust in them. They refused to wait. What happened to that gallon of pessimism? Was it too much? I could see you being one of those rich snobs who refuse to look towards the impoverished and broken Americans. You probably think that you can only pity those who live in abject hated misery. I guess it's easier for you to believe that there is no hope for them, that everyone will let them pass by, and that there is just no change that's not part of humanity, and that you could just get away with transferring that pessimism into a smaller bottle again. Don't act as if I can't see you. Drink it as you would water. Jesus. Anyway, let's just find common ground in the fact that there is an avoidable anguish that stems from those corrupted men who promise for a better tomorrow. They give us false hope that I, myself, can mold reality into a beautiful picture. That's preposterous! A better tomorrow doesn't exist without collective action. But Americans are all without passion, afraid of a negative reaction they hide within their minds until change becomes an abstraction. But alas, I understand. All humans would prefer to indulge in every sip of water and stare at the ground, ignoring all the big problems that come. Even you, as surprisingly resilient as you are, will eventually succumb to your temptation and become invigorated with the numb feeling of dread. There's no shame in it, though. On the contrary, we should bask in the sheer meaninglessness of life, as a student typically does every weekend at a time. So, how about it? Take whatever is left of your pessimism and chug it. Feel what it's like to be the average American. Understand the pain that reality has brought upon us, and let us understand each other, man to man, through the inner hatred most people possess, and you know you would rather express. For that dark art is truly what paves the way for a better tomorrow.
know, it's just a smile on my face.
But in any case, I think we should get down to business. You know, talk about history. Talk about how, in general, in the 1930s, things were just crap. The fact that people lived through economic hardships, and that Fred Astaire was, I guess you can say, a moral arbiter. He had no grievances. Not pessimistic, not optimistic. He was just a person who created art, entertainment for entertainment's sake. That's what I call a mark of a true hero. Okay, so as for myself, dressed up as this hero, I would just like to say that I have learned a lot from this project. Namely, one, do not procrastinate on it, and number two, please, that I learned to discern the difference between wise and foolish pessimism. Or at least someone tried. I mean, I was pessimistic. I mean, I put meaning where there should have been no meaning. It's just an irony. But I hope that when you, as you sort of go on to your artistic careers, that you sort of understand when to listen to your voice and when not. And if you take anything from this performance, at the very least, you should break outside this comfort zone that I sort of put myself in.